I'm sure that there must be a button that gets you from the main menu to the game, but I find that thinking hard enough about it does the same thing. Atari returned to the success of Pong with Rebound, which was Pong with Gravity. It was originally titled Volleyball. I can see why. It's quite a bit of fun to play, and the ball bounces very fluidly. Sadly, it's difficult to play on today's keyboards. You can adjust the sensitivity on the DICE emulator, but too low and you can't move fast enough to catch up with the ball, and too fast and you overcompensate, and muck up when trying to correct shots like this. I keep thinking that there are game-breaking exploits, but something always manages to fix it. Bounce more than three times on your own side and you lose. The net in the middle gets higher if you're good enough, and so on. This game is quite a bit of fun, and would probably be even more fun if I wasn't just playing against myself. Nope, getting off the main menu seems to be done by mashing the keyboard. Elimination, aka Quadrapong, was Atari reinventing the wheel once again in the form of a four-player Pong match. Using the default controls, it's a lot harder than the original, which probably reflects the thousands of hours of experience that players already had at this point. Remember that I'm forever alone, so this is really, really hard for me to play. As far as I can tell, it's not as polished or as fun as the older versions, and there isn't any bot support. Perhaps 4-player Pong was to help clear the lines of people queuing for their go on the arcade machines. Oh come on! I just hate it when this happens! This occurred twice in the same single game that I played. I'm ashamed to admit it, but the one player I couldn't find the controls for kicked the asses of the three I could. Maze War was the first 3D first-person game. I couldn't get a working version online, which tends to be a problem with these older games. It featured your opponents as sinister eyeballs that would move about inside a labyrinth. Somewhat creepy. It's worth noting that there were several arcade games released, though unfortunately it's beyond my ability to show them here. Atari's first launch was Touch Me, where things flash up in a certain order and the player has to repeat them without making any mistakes. They also released a gun game called Quack, where you had to shoot the ducks. Makes sense. They also released an arcade game by the name of Grand Track 10. Remember Empire from 1973? Well, they're back with Space Sim this year, which was a 3D, 32-player space game. This was apparently the first of its type. I can believe that. And finally there was Tank, where two players controlled tanks around a maze, firing shells at each other. Although it was made by Key Games, this was a subsidiary of Atari. Maybe they released it to look as though they weren't a huge gaming monopoly. Anyway, the tank game appears quite frequently in various forms. Well done, Atari. Next week, I look at 1975. Will a 64-player MMO be released on the Plato platform? Will Atari release another version of Pong? You'll just have to wait.